No, but she... No, but you don't understand. The video games you've been playing, they already got the first half of your military training done. You think I'm fucking around? I'm not. You see, listen, during World War I and some of World War II, a lot of men had never fired a rifle before in their life, right? So when they got to fucking boot camp, it wasn't just about getting the men in shape, teaching them tactics, teaching them hand-to-hand combat. You had to teach these guys, hey, listen, put the stock against your shoulder. No, don't close one eye. Keep both eyes open. And after you pull the trigger, you gotta raise the bolt, pull it back to rechamber another round, push it forward, and slam it down. We had to teach these guys how to operate the weapons that they would be using. Here's my theory. You already know that the U.S. military plays a large role in the creation of games like Call of Duty and Battlefield. That's not a secret. When the game is over and you see the credits, it says things like special thanks to the U.S. military or General Don Baker, whatever, right? Here's the thing. 90% of you here have never held an MP5 or an M16 or an M1911 or an MP40, right? Yet, if I handed you one and told you to reload it, you probably could. Now, it gets even crazier because think about what I'm saying. M4, M16, MP5, all these are. All I'm saying is an assembly of letters and numbers. MP5. That could mean fucking anything. But 90% of you are picturing an MP5 right now. You understand that you gotta pull the slide back and click that bitch up before you can pull out the magazine. Put that mag back in and slam it back down. Same thing with like a fucking M16. If I handed you an M16, which you've probably never held before in your life, you'd be like, okay, well, the magazine release button's right there. And then I have to put another magazine in, and then, I gotta charge it back, and I think I'm good to go. That is intentional and genius and fucking insane!
Oh, hey. What's going on, everybody? My name's Kobe Scroby. Welcome back to Open Roads! Thanks so much for coming to hang out with me tonight. I really do appreciate it. If you enjoy the stream, make sure you follow, turn on notifications, and if you'd like to support the channel, you can subscribe for $5 or you can subscribe for free with a Twitch Prime. If you connect an Amazon Prime account to your Twitch account, you'll get a free Prime subscription every month. If you use it here, you can join the server for free and not have to watch ads. And Satisfactory 1.0 is releasing this year with the story. So you can come play with us on the private server. Otherwise, you got to be lucky and get gifted a sub. What's up, Dishonest and Zalen? Good to see you. Thanks for stopping by. You guys know how I feel about those kind of games, but yeah, I know that, like, the military sponsor and Call of Duty and stuff like that. I don't know the names of the guns. I know the calibers. I know what the calibers mean. I am sure that I could operate probably any gun that you gave me. I might have to look at it for a second because they're all a little bit different. Like, for example, my handgun doesn't have a safety. It has a trigger safety so that you have to pull the right spot on the trigger to be able to pull it all the way. And if you pull it up too high, it won't get past that first little notch, which I didn't know when I bought it. But that's how it is. But yeah, I don't know, like M16, I mean, that's a gun that everybody's heard of, probably even my 8-year-old. Not exactly sure what an MP5 is. I know what an AK is. I know what an AR is. I know what a 1911 is. But other than that, Like, when we play games, when we play shooter games and I pick up a gun and it says, like, SCAR or whatever, I don't necessarily know what that means until I get the gun and I try to use it. But, yeah. So, is he saying that young people playing games like that are, like, being trained to think, being groomed to think that they want to join the military? Because it's already been proven that shooter violent video games do not cause shooters, school shootings, violence in general. I got a light on over here. This is how it usually is. And I just set this on the table. Is that better? Okay, old way. New way. You like that better? I guess so. My whole face is lit. Without this one, this side's dark because my light's over here. Does it matter? Does it make it too bright? I think I could turn the brightness down. MP5 is SMG. See, I didn't know that, but I do know that SMG means submachine gun. Prepares us for battle knowledge wise, not violence wise. Okay. No light. Light. I turned the brightness down a little bit. This is what these same lights that's behind me. Whoa. You can change the colors. They're just cycling through. I got another one. I got four. All the light. Should I turn it up brighter? See, the reason that this light on this side is pointing up at the ceiling, but it also reflects off my TV, so I have to turn it, because especially if I'm playing a darker game, the reflection makes it so I can't see anything on the damn screen. So it's pointing up at the ceiling and the wall, and it's reflecting back at me this way. But this side, I'm noticing this side of my face is dark. But if I keep this over here, I just don't want it to, like, wash out and look worse. Is that too bright? That looks too bright. How about that? You need to be glowing. Brightness maxed. You need to be glowing with a green screen behind you. Well, if I ever get, like, my own damn office, maybe I can have one day. And then you wouldn't get this whole box of my head. Maybe I could make it so that the game shows through except for just me. But it seems like if I get this townhouse, I'm going to be setting this up in my living room. It's probably going to be this same thing, though. It's going to be this couch, this table, and a TV. But it's going to be in front of the front door, though, so, like, I gotta figure out how, if the TV is here, either I put my PC at the TV and the wires run across to me, or I put my PC at me and I run the wires across to the TV. I don't know. It's something I'm gonna have to figure out how to do. You can get portable green screen. I was thinking maybe one that I could, like, could pull down or something. Doesn't have to be mounted anywhere. Yeah, it's just something I never even really thought about doing because I only really started using the camera when I started streaming. So it's only been a couple, 3 years, but I don't know. We'll have to see how everything sets up in whatever house I end up getting. Uh-oh. I might not even get this house, I think I'm going to. Alright, so so last thing we did, at the beginning we were in Grandma's old house, which is the house that me, the daughter, and my mom lived in too. Grandma died, she mortgaged the house like 3 times, so they're selling the house out from under us. We looked around at all the stuff that Grandma left behind, and we found a secret, like a secret door in the attic that had this book that was cut out and it had a key inside. And there was like, Grandma had like a secret lover or something. So we came over here, we got in the car. We came over here to the summer house, which no one's been at for like 30 years. This used to be Mom's bedroom in the van. So we got to go into her sister's, my aunt's bedroom and find the keys. Yeah, this looks like somebody put two trailers like back to back. And then they, you know, like they put four trailers together to make this place. I guess it could be like a manufactured home, a modular home, or whatever they call it. We get a green suit. Yeah, that's funny. Like if you couldn't see any of my body except my head. Luckily the father is dead and the mother kept it a secret. Well, I was texting with my dad on the way here. Unless the mom went so far as to set up somebody to text me back, you know? Like someone to pretend to be my dad? Do you think she would have gone that far? So yeah, it's double wide and double long. So I had a trailer when I went to college. I bought a trailer, I lived in it for a year when I went to college, and then I sold it when I left. And it was like this, there was some front, there was a front door, and then there was a back door like, there was a back door like here, and that was the end of the trailer. Well, no, I guess there was a little bit, but this is too long. It's, one trailer is not this long, so it's like, it's like one and a half length and double wide. But they also, you know, when you see trucks, like a half a house going down the interstate, this could be one of those too, I suppose. Then they just stick it together. So I said the word kiddo in the text seemed like something an aunt would say. Oh. The mother avoids talking about the father quite a bit as well. Okay. Interesting. Well, I guess we didn't check out back yet. Let's check out back and then we'll go inside. We gotta go into the aunt's bedroom, find the keys for the van. Gaze at Vista.
Okay. It's out there. Somewhere. That buried bootlegger gold.
Uh-huh. Bigfoot, too, I hear.
Do you think he found the gold already?
What makes you so sure Bigfoot's a he?
Oh, I love it. Equal opportunity cryptids. Very forward-thinking.
It's 2003, Tess. Anyone can be a Bigfoot.
So anyway, I think I was saying the reason I don't have this other light shining at my face... it's because I can't stand the lights shining in my eyes. Even with it over here on the table, it's still kind of shining in the side of my eye. 2003, I was in foster care. Not me. Dishonest was. So... did your parents got you back then? Like, your parents are your biological parents, right? Okay. That's what I thought. But then I was like, wait. I guess I don't know for sure. It's locked. Dude, there's gonna be secrets all over this place. I don't see anything obvious, though. How about the scarecrow garden?
Did you do these with Grandma?
No, August did. I never had a green thumb. She loved helping my mother in the garden.
Really?
Why do you say it like that?
I don't know. Can you picture August getting her hands dirty out in the garden now?
I guess not. But if my mother was ever out in the garden, she was out there with her, helping the best she could. I remember one year, maybe when she was six, she started crying so hard when it came time to pick the berries and vegetables. But the plants worked so hard growing them. You can't just take them.
Aw. Well, now I feel bad for the plants.
She was a sensitive kid.
So am I. So what happened?
Hmm?
To August. She doesn't seem so sensitive now.
Oh. Life happened, I guess.
Yeah, we're ripping off the plants. The fruit of a plant, I believe, is comparable to the plant's ovaries, because inside are the seeds. But we're ripping them off and we're eating them. It's not very nice. They're the first couple to graduate from the NA program, and they received an award from the Terminator himself, and were on the news to inspire other addicts to get sober. Everywhere they went, they got recognized. Really? Dang.
Is this a trailer home?
It's a mobile home.
Ah.
What did I just say?
They're not the same thing. A trailer home hooks up to the back of a truck and can be towed around. You can take it from place to place. A mobile home arrives on a trailer, like towed by a big truck.
Go on.
A mobile home doesn't have wheels.
Well, why didn't you just say that?
Well, I will admit it took me a moment to untangle the nuances.
I think that a mobile home and a trailer are the same thing. A modular home or a manufactured home is what she's talking about, where it arrives on a trailer and then they put it together. They stick the pieces together. Dang, what'd you guys do here before you left? It looks like dirt. This is cool, though. The ceiling is not cool. You guys just left stuff everywhere? Why is there so much dirt? Like, looks like someone came in here with a shovel and dumped it on the ground. Does TV advertising really work? No! You know what advertising does work? No, it's not time. Shell Shock? The Family Garden. 75 cents. Oh, there's a Lovecraft game sale going on right now. From today, for 4th to the 8th. And I found a game on there that's not out yet that I put on my wish list. That looks really cool, and that's why I sent out the notifications, and then I was looking through those. And then I added another game to my library that was free. So I need to look through those within the next couple days. What the hell happened there? I can't get that note. There's like a note on the couch. Yeah. The perfect ones always happen before the hourly ad break. Yeah. Opal, I'm having so much fun. It's a total blast out here. Really. You have to come. I know you go out to your little summer house every year with your family, but I really think you should consider working at the park with me next year. It's all people our age running the rides and concessions and games. Plus, when the park closes, you can ride the rides as much as you want, as long as whoever's running it isn't a jerk. Yeah, because if you get on there and they start it, you can't get off. Promise you'll come with me next summer. How are things out in the sticks? Are you still working at the drive-in? Oh, hell yeah. If you don't have any luck, the guys out here wait until you come out. If you don't have any luck with guys out there, wait until you come out here. The guys are unreal. I've seen stuff that would make your hair curl. Like what? Say hi to your family from me. I'm going to write you every week, just like last year, so don't forget to write back. Your friend who is having lots of fun and wants you here desperately, Lori.
Mom, you know what it sounds like. You had a Francine.
I guess I did.
I've never heard of Lori before. Are you still in touch with her?
It was short for Dolores. Maybe you've heard me talk about my old friend Dolores?
No, I don't think so.
We haven't spoken in years. One of those friends you have in high school and then college happens and, you know.
That's never going to happen with me and me and Francine. That'll probably happen with me and Francine. You know, I had some really close friends in high school, and then out of high school, I waited 2 years before I went to Wyoming to go to college. And we were like, did everything. I even worked with one of them. So, and then the days that we weren't at work, because we worked Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday through Thursday, he'd come over to my house. We'd connect the giant trailer to my truck, and we'd drive around out in the country and find cars just sitting out in people's yards and see if they want to get rid of them. We had at least 10 cars over at my parents' farm at one time, cars and trucks. But after I left, I think I went over to his house one time when I went back home when I was in college, and I haven't talked to him yet since. So it's been since like 2006 probably. So it happens. If you move away, I'm going to say it's never going to happen.
That's never going to happen with me and Francine. We'll still be friends when I'm as old as you. A very long time from now. Like, so long from now.
Wait, you're not implying I'm old?
No, of course not. But God, it's gonna be a long time from now.
So how old do you think she is, the daughter? She seems like 16? I don't remember. Wait, she had a graduation book. She was gonna be a senior next year, so maybe she is 15 or 16. And the mom is like 40? If I remember correctly. These have seen better days.
These have seen better days.
Yeah, it's a shame they've gotten so moth-eaten.
Yeah, this taxidermy must have been beautiful when it was new. What she say? It's a shame they've gotten moth-eaten. I meant when they were alive.
I meant when they were alive.
Right.
I think hunting is really rude. Like, leave the poor animals alone.
You know, people have been hunting animals since we lived in caves.
Right. Before there were supermarkets. Or shotguns. Hunt like a caveman, and maybe I'll give you a pass. Did Grandpa shoot these?
Mm-hmm. Well, the pheasant. I shot the deer.
Dang. Mom, that's kind of awesome. Mom, that's messed up.
Mom! That's kind of awesome. I mean, as noted, hunting in general is rude and unnecessary, but still, it's kind of badass. You That's were hard. My age when you shot it?
Younger. Our father took us hunting during the summers when we'd stay out here. Well, mostly just me. I always did all right with hunting. I could kind of, what's the word? Compartmentalize it? I don't think August could, though. I only saw her fire a gun once. A little .22 hunting rifle. She didn't want to, but my dad wouldn't let her give up. He said we weren't heading back until August took her shot. So she aimed and fired and missed. The deer ran off, and August cried all the way home. That was August's first and last hunting trip. Our father didn't have much patience for that kind of, he had a real thing for, you know, not letting your emotions get in the way.
Maybe it's good to let your emotions get in the way sometimes. Maybe they're trying to tell you something.
That .22 rifle would not have killed a deer anyway. It just would have wounded it. School is full of chaotic people, so I'm glad I have no ties to them. I had some good friends, but I haven't talked to any of them in a long time. I found a key.
Elderly coworker just said this to me right now. Doing a good job at work is like being a good hoe. The better you are, the more you get fucked. But that's really resonating with me right now.
Doing a good job at work is like being a good hoe. The better you are, the more you get effed. Alright, I got a key.
Ooh, a little tiny key. What do you think it's for?
Probably unlocking something.
Ugh, maybe a desk drawer?
Also, the windows are open on this place for the last 30 years. We found a little tiny key. I wonder what it unlocks. Invitation, you're invited. August 18th, 7, Cindy and Marks? Yeah. I can verify. Darling, I know I'm running from something, but I have never felt so free. I just crossed the border, and I'm writing you from the desk in a room at a motel that's hidden off a little side road far from the main thoroughway. There's more driving to do before I find us a little place to settle down, but before long, I'll have a return address for you to write back to. Don't miss me too much. True Color, Puffenkuchen, Michigan, 1969. Puffenkuchen.
Well, would you look at this?
Wait, I wanted to flip
it. A postcard from the mystery man.
What was he running from?
The cops, the mob,
his conscience.
I don't know if you can outrun your conscience by going to Canada.
You can if, I'm trying to think of a Canada joke.
Eh?
It's not working.
That's okay. I'll give you an A for effort.
Bested.
Being racist towards Canadians. Greetings from Canada. Amiri Uskedmere. Might be French. Police station 30 miles from me sees $1.3 million worth of marijuana. You should have got some and sold it. No, never mind. You can do that now, but it's really hard to do it legally. A lot of work. Can. Fan? Dude, this place would be so dirty and rusty. I mean, it'd be so much worse than this if these windows were open for 30 years. I don't know what happened here. How did this just happen to break over the years? Box of cracker. Whoops, you can't say that. Dog food. All right, we got a key. Yeah, and what the hell happened here? How does the water heater just fall out?
Sheesh, what happened here?
Looks like the wall gave way. Water damage, I guess.
What is this thing?
It's the water heater.
Oh, that's why you said water damage. I get it, I'm following along. Well, it's not going anywhere now. Can we climb over it?
No! God, look at all that rusty metal.
I'm up on my tetanus shots, aren't I?
We're not risking it.
Well, what's that thingy back there?
Ooh, trapdoor.
A maintenance hatch? For getting down into the crawl space under the house.
Is there any other way into the crawl space?
I think there's a way to get in from around the back. Why are you acting so excited?
Well, if we could get into the crawl space, we could climb back up out of that hatch and get over to that side of the mobile home to find more stuff.
I'm not sure why you're using the plural here.
And also, I really want to see if there's any cool, creepy stuff under there. Like a skeleton.
Listen, you can give it a peek if you want, but there is no way I'm crawling under there with you. You're on your own.
Hey, no problem. More cool, creepy stuff for me.
Dude, there's going to be so many spiders and bugs and dead animals underneath this place. A freaking water heater fell through the wall, and we can't get around it. But there's a weird hatch in the floor. Maybe I could go under the house and come up through there. There's access to the crawl space around back. It's okay to be racist to Canadians. They've got more jokes to make about us. Can we say saltine? I don't know. The song got banned for calling someone a cracker. Or, you know, for a couple days or something. St. Benedict Messenger, Pfunkchen, Michigan. It's just a bowling, men's league, finance committee, choir, confirmation class. I had to do that when I was a child, confirmation. That's why I can list all the books of the Old Testament in order. This is just like weddings. Linda Fuller and Dick Greenson. This is just like a schedule for the church. Luncheon. Oh, luncheon, eh? What's Fallout? It's a first-person survival crafting shooter game in the post-apocalyptic future. And how can you be safe? Fallout is nothing more than particles of matter in the air, made radioactive by nuclear or thermonuclear explosions. When an atomic or hydrogen bomb is exploded close to the ground, thousands of tons of atomized earth, building materials, rocks, and gases are sucked upward, sometimes to a height of 80,000 feet or more. I never even thought of that. The mushroom cloud is the heat going up, so it's sucking stuff up, and then when it mushrooms out, everything falls back down. I never even considered that happening. 80,000 feet or more. They help form the mushroom cloud. Hey, I think I just said that. Which is always seen with one of those explosions. Some of these radioactive particles spill out in the immediate area of the explosion soon after it occurs, but others may occur by the upper winds. Others may be carried by the upper winds for many miles. Sooner or later, however, they settle to Earth. This is called fallout. Don't get discouraged. Don't get panicky. Follow these simple rules. Prepare a shelter area in your home or backyard, whether you live in a big city or the country. Stock your shelter with a 7-day supply of emergency food and water. Get a radio, preferably battery operated or crank, and keep it in a safe place. Mark the Conalrad? I've never seen that word before. Conalrad? Frequencies, civil defense news, and instructions will be provided at these frequencies. If you think you have been in a serious fallout area, remove your outer clothing and wash the exposed parts of your body thoroughly. To sum it up, Americans are hard to scare. Of course, we are worried about the forces science has unlocked. We would not be intelligent human beings otherwise, but this problem can be solved, as others have been, by American ingenuity and careful preparation now. See your local civil defense office today. Let civil defense help you to help yourself and the nation to be prepared. So, I don't remember. I think it was on HBO. But if you want something cool to watch, let me look. I think it's just called Chernobyl, but it's like a it's like a 5-part mini series. Is it this one? Yeah. Just called Chernobyl, HBO original. This one with the guy. Oh, maybe this will help. This one. It's really good. Like the first, Laura and I put it on one day, and the first episode was so good that we just binged the whole thing in the same day. It's awesome. As long as we're talking about nuclear fallout. So, when I got home from work, Will wanted to go play with these darts that he has that are like, they whistle as they go through the air. You hook them up to like a rubber band and you go, psh, and they go, psh, and they make the whistling noise. So we took the dog and we went and did that for a little bit. And then when I came back, the screen on my phone didn't work. Like all the buttons worked fine, but the touchscreen wouldn't do anything. And I was looking for my old phone, which I know is in this room, and I couldn't find it anywhere. And I still never found it. And then eventually I was able to get the phone to restart. And now it works. I thought I was going to have to go get a new phone. Study warns by the year 2531, every person in Japan could have the same last name. Why? How does that happen? I don't think I'll be around long enough to see that. Alright, I gotta find a locked drawer. Oh, did that unlock that? She just crossed out the little key thing. Just because the small population? Is Japan that small? There's lots of people in Japan, isn't there? Darling, I've been driving up and down the highways and byways looking for the perfect spot. Somewhere secluded, where no one would think to look. With a little bit of space, and I know you always liked a place near the water, I'll find something soon. Just keep biding your time and don't let on. Don't let on? But like, don't tell anybody? Come find us. Merrimack Caverns. Jesse James Hideout. Stanton, Missouri.
Aha! They were really
million?
Gonna run away together, huh?
He thought so anyway. Whoever he Teddy was.
Bear.
Why do you think Grandma decided not to run off with him?
Well, maybe she just came to her senses. She could have gotten swept up in all the emotions and everything after Father died, and then when the time came, she thought better of it.
Maybe. Or...
maybe he thought better of it. Maybe something super messed up happened.
Like what?
Nuclear fallout.
Okay. He was driving on these secluded back roads and whatnot, and he picks up a hitchhiker. And the hitchhiker gets in, and he asks him where he's headed. And the hitchhiker says, "All the way to the end of the line, man." And the hitchhiker's just staring off into the distance like he's lost at some faraway place. And then all of a sudden, with no warning, he pulls out this huge rusty Bowie knife.
It's actually pronounced Bowie.
What? No, it's like the last name, like David Bowie.
Different last name. Bowie.
Are you just messing with me?
No, that's how it's pronounced.
Okay, well, anyway, maybe this guy got killed by a crazy hitchhiker. That's all I'm saying.
Well, that would be super messed up.
Unless it's restrictive marriage laws change? I don't know. The hitchhiker reminded me of this new podcast called Creepcast. And it's Wendigoon and Meat Canyon. And they have been reading scary stories from like r/no sleep and stuff like that. And one of them was called The Left-Right Game, which I'd never heard of. And they have two episodes of it that are like 4 or 5 hours each. It's awesome. I need more long videos like that. But it's really good. The concept is when you pull out of your driveway, you take the first left, the first right, the first left, the first right, the first left, the first right. You just keep doing it. And as you do it, you start to kind of get into an alternate reality, or reality starts to change around you. It's really good. But everything that they've done on that channel so far is so good. Scary internet stories. I don't know much about it either. It's a headline. What about by 2030, we will have damaged the planet beyond repair? Like, there's no coming back. We're coming up on that faster than I think a lot of people think. Or the planet's just going to be like, screw you guys, and just wipe us out. There's the gun. But yeah, when we piss the planet off, it usually doesn't even have a problem just wiping us out. I can see the outside. Oh my god. I don't believe she's not falling through this floor right now.
Oh, look at this big pink guy.
Kurt won that for me. At the fair.
Who's Kurt?
Kurt?
We met at the drive-in diner.
You had a summer fling? Was he cute?
I thought he was very handsome. And he rode a motorcycle.
Oh my god, a bad boy?
Well, honestly, I fell for him pretty hard that summer.
Girls don't really like motorcycles that much, do they?
Cool. On his motorcycle?
Not in my experience.
He was very romantic.
Oh, no.
No, not like that. Well, a little like that.
Ah, no. So, what happened? Did you break up with him, or...
Teddy bear flying back there.
I don't remember. It was just a summer thing. It doesn't really matter.
Wow. Did I hit a nerve?
Hey, maybe we should keep looking around for more relevant things.
Isn't it weird to think of your mom as, like, a teenager or a 20-year-old, you know, doing the same kind of stuff that you did or do? Or even grandma? Dude, why did this fall out? Like, it broke the pipe off and everything. I don't see how this could have happened. This is impossible. Alright, we're going around back. I still don't have the key for this guy. So yeah, when I was in the kitchen ends here. The stove is like here, and then there's the hallway. You couldn't get to this door from there. Mom, it's locked. How am I supposed to get under the house? Dude, all the windows are open. This place is... crashed. There's nothing left to do with it but bulldoze it. You'd have to replace the roof, the ceiling, the floor, probably most of the walls.
What's in here?
That's just August's old room. Let's try and find some other way in.
She has a door to the outside. We can't get into August's room from the outside. Maybe there's another way in. Yeah? How about through there? Through there? How about the roof? I bet if you climbed up on the roof, you could fall through it. There you go. Climb this thing. Get up there. Just push on this wall. I bet you can walk through it. Yeah, so... wait. These drawers... don't work. What am I supposed to do? Did I miss, like... another key or something? I can't see my inventory. There's a weird hatch in the floor, maybe. There's access to the crawl space around back. Okay. So I guess I just missed a crawl space somewhere. Oh, I bet this place smells too. Like water damage and mold. Dead animals. Alright, so we're looking for a crawl space. Is it behind this tire? Oh!
So this is how we get into the crawl space?
You keep saying we.
So this is how intrepid people with an innate sense of curiosity get into the crawl space?
Among other personality traits, yes.
Fine then. I'll go it alone. You're probably too frail to get in here anyway. Those creaky knees of yours.
Wow. Okay, into the filthy crawl space you go.
See you on the other side.
I'm in.
Ugh.
And it's just sitting on cinder blocks, holding it up. This here kind of reminds me a little bit of, Tell Me Why. But there were, like, the kids played down here. Why are there tires under here? The kids played down here and there were toys and stuff. Where's all the spiders? Why are there more tires over here? How did this get here? Somebody would have had to drag it all the way back here. This place is gonna fall down. Skeleton!
Oh, cool.
I knew it. Dead animals. Water shut off? You gotta, like, go all the way out. Oh, that's, like, the sewage, probably. There's a hatch. Before I do it.
Ooh, this is good. Mom's gotta see this.
I'm writing you from our new home, right on the water. I was looking and looking, and I realized there was no better home for us than one we could just pull up anchor and split if we really needed to. So I bought us a houseboat. It's really something else. Bought it from an older fellow who'd kept it perfect and was just done having to maintain it in his autumn years. Autumn years? I've never heard that. There's a rumor they're going to dam this river up, but that's a long time coming, if it happens at all. Now just to get you and those kids moved up here, I hope it's been a good summer. Right back, discreetly. And let's make plans for the big move. Something I've learned since Leo died is that being loaded with cash is the only way to live. Get ready to leave all your worries behind. Libertyville, Michigan? Next. Holy crap, did he bought that? What's it called? The Indian? The Idol? The Idol On? Alright, here we go.
Mom, I found a way in. Hang on, I'll open the back door. Hey, Mom, I found something. Look, look.
Another letter. He wanted to live with Grandma on a boat. Maybe we can figure out where the boat was by looking at the photo.
It looks like, well,
that's a giant
it looks
boat.
Like a boat.
A houseboat.
Can't see much of the surrounding area.
It's near trees? Maybe we can look for some of those.
A place in Canada.
This one
with
right behind
trees.
Her.
That narrows it down.
Yep, there's barely any trees in Canada. Official, how many trees are in Canada? I don't believe you can see light coming through.
Do you remember? Well, did it seem like Grandma wanted to
leave my father? I mean, I guess when I was around your age, I started wondering why they were together in the first place. They didn't seem to
make sense together?
Yeah.
Huh. I remember when I started wondering that about you and Dad. Why you were together. You're both so different. Did you used to have more in common?
Well, when you're together at first, everything about each other is new. It can cover up a lot of things. But when you get used to each other, that's when it can be hard. But sometimes, you know, by that point, it's too late.
Too late?
Because you're already married, because you have a kid.
Because you have a kid?
Well, that can be one factor.
So you think you and Dad would have split up a lot sooner if I wasn't around? Well, I'm sorry I held everything up, okay? Maybe you would have been happier if you hadn't been stuck with Dad for so long.
Honey, that's not how it is. It's not as simple as that, and it's not because of you. There's a lot more to it. We'll talk about it someday.
When's someday?
Not today.
Then when?
Not today.
So that's Mom? I don't remember which one's older. Yeah, that looks kind of more like red hair. I think that's Mom. Yeah, this is funny. My grandpa had a haircut kind of like that too. Oh, really? Kurt, about 2 hours drive. Kurt? Grand Rapids, Michigan?
What's this about?
Oh, that was the town where Kurt lived. You know, we were a summer thing, but we were planning on how we could keep seeing each other once we both went home after the summer. I guess I was feeling pretty lost. I latched on to him and held on tight. He became my plan for how I would be okay.
And that didn't work out?
Yeah, like these things often do.
So how'd you end up with Dad?
Sorry?
Well, you didn't end up with Kurt. How'd you end up with Dad?
Oh, it was a lot of years later that I met your dad. After college, I moved back to Greenville for my bookkeeping job. It was actually when I was in one of the first plays I performed in at the Andromeda. Your dad was in the audience. He hung around outside the stage door after the show and he flagged me down. He said there was a problem with the production. He was so distracted by my beauty that he couldn't pay attention to anything else going on in the play.
She's pretty hot. Want to do Deceit 2 tomorrow or Saturday, Among Us, but with extra steps? Sure. Let's, in 4 minutes when I run the ad, let's watch a trailer. Oh, that's so romantic. Oh, that's so lame. Wait, what did he do? She's so beautiful, he couldn't pay attention to anything else.
Aw, that's so romantic. It's like something out of a rom-com.
I found it endearing at the time. He was very persistent.
Was Dad big into local theater?
No. He told me later that he'd actually been at the play on a date with someone else.
Ooh.
He told her he needed to head home, then hung around the theater to talk to me.
Wow. Bold. Did you find that endearing?
I guess at the time I found it flattering. And a little funny. I should have realized it was a red flag.
Mm-hmm. You don't want to be with somebody who is, like, cheating to come see you, because that's what they do. They're going to do the same thing to you. He may not have been cheating. They may have just been, like, on a date and not together, but just, like, in general. If somebody's doing something to their current partner to come see you, they're going to do it again to you with someone else. Wait, are you saying Dad cheated on you?
Wait, are you saying Dad cheated on you?
Oh, God, no. No, 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 no. Just...
The game volume's too loud?
You know, it's a sleazy move.
Or the...
So...
Or the voices.
Not the kind of thing Kurt would have done?
Oh, I don't know.
I didn't see what she said now. Here, I can turn that up. I can turn it down here. I can also turn my gain up on my mic too, but I don't want that to be too loud.
Go Mechanics! Oh man, I forgot that August had this.
Ford
I let
State
her keep
College
it when
Mechanics.
I moved into the van.
But August didn't even go to Ford State.
She almost did. We were both so excited to, growing up. Don't you remember Grandma talking about how much she loved it?
I remember her talking about how sexist it was.
Yeah, well, everything was sexist back then. But we're a Ford State family. You'll be a triple legacy.
I'm not going to be a triple legacy. I don't even know if I want to go to college. Yeah, I guess.
I don't even know if I want to go to college.
What do you mean you don't know if you want to go to college? Of course you're going.
I can make my own choices.
What kind of choice is that? To be broke?
I'm not gonna be broke. I've been working really hard on my design business.
You got it all wrong. If you go to college, you're broke. For the next 30 years.
And August didn't go to college.
August was lucky. She's talented, but she's also lucky.
When I'm 18.
Look, I don't want to talk about this anymore. It's not a discussion.
Fine.
Howdy.
Well, howdy there. What's your name, buddy?
My name is... that's not gonna work. Well, if you're not broke and you don't want to watch ads, you can subscribe for $5. But if you are broke, you can subscribe for free by using your Twitch Prime or someone else's Amazon Prime account connected to your Twitch account, and you'll get a free Prime subscription every month. Otherwise, you gotta wait and hope you're lucky enough to get gifted a sub. It's both. I don't know if there's much you can do. I'm noticing in some scenes the voices are a lot louder than other scenes. Unless you spent time in the system, then at least community college is free. Can confirm we are all broke. That's why it's better to subscribe with a Twitch Prime. So I'm going to run a 3-minute ad break that'll shut off the pre-roll ads for the next hour. We're going to look up Deceit 2. And Dishonest has got some videos here.
Time to play.
Peggy 16. Whoa. Is this it?
Lisa! I've got to do something. Oh no!
I just watched a trailer for Content Warning before I started tonight.
Buddy, you all right?
It's $8.
I'll be honest with you, I'm convinced it's Priya.
Alex, stop! I would never do anything to harm anyone.
Liar! I have a hard time believing that.
Weren't you the one suspicious of Lisa?
Emergency meeting?
Nina?
It was obviously her. Of course she tried to deny it.
Yeah, maybe you're right.
When am I ever wrong? We have to vote her out now. Hurry, guys.
Chang, we have to.
I hope you're right.
Nina, wait. Alex, it's you. No, 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 no.
What's What's up, Malika? We're thinking about playing this game tomorrow or Saturday.
It's Mina and Alex. It's them. Give me the key.
It's free. Get the key. That's interesting. Content warning, you have to buy unless you grab the game when I posted about it. Doing good, just chilling. I think I pissed a few of the Last of Us people off by sending in a video of me dodging someone's bullets. They say it's exploiting. Yeah, let's watch it. Angry Russian is teaching me Python. Free. Add to library. Bam. Let's do it. Next.
Oh my.
/4/22, never mind the first one. Alright, let's watch Malik real quick here.
I got a rifle.
Oh, so when you switch back, they can't hit you.
Got a rifle.
And he's shooting at you. Well, I guess they should. I guess they should get good. Got that sweet headshot at the end. They say I should stand still and take the bullets or just don't peek. Can't you play the game? However, like, that's how the game works, right? Tell them to do it. Can save it for next ad break. Let me get it back. And I'll stash it over here. The official Flat Earth recruitment video.
Do you f*** your cousin? When you put in mental effort, do babies die? Do you think 9/11 was an inside job, yet you're more than willing to attend public conventions to preach what you think is the biggest government conspiracy of all time while putting in no effort to hide your identity? Does critical thinking make you softer than non-family members do? Can you disprove evolution using only the Bible and your existence? Were you conceived at Olive Garden? Do you think the moon landing was filmed in a Hollywood studio and now you just laugh at how bad the footage looks? Or asked a different way, do you think the government tried to fake humanity's greatest achievement, got this, and said, yep, that's a print, they'll believe it, fuck you, we forgot the stars. Perfect, you're just who we're looking
for. Oh, there's no stars?
Got this, and said, yep, that's a print, they'll believe it, fuck
we forgot the stars.
You, we forgot the stars. Perfect. You're just who we're looking for here at the Flat Earth Society. That's right, the Flat Earth Society is a growing movement that now has members in the double-digit IQ bracket, almost. But we're not just a movement, we're a community. Because we know how tough it was being bullied in school just because your parents are related. But
we now have members in the double-digit IQ bracket, almost. Are you mad because you're getting bullied because your parents are related?
But we're not just a movement, we're a community. Because we know how tough it was being bullied in school just because your parents are related. But here at the Flat Earth Society, you're not alone. Because that story comes up more than sometimes. We also have a panel of experts that don't believe anything experts say unless those experts say things that our experts agree with. The way science was intended. We're not sheep, but we do fuck them. So what are you waiting for? Give us a call over at 1-888-GET-OFF-THAT-COUSIN and come on down to the rootinest, tootinest, most funnest convention of silly gooses in town.org/ the only thing worse than facts is NASA and incest laws.com #.net. IQ must be 18 or lower to call.
That one's funny. Not this guy again. This freaking guy.
Oh my god. Have y'all seen the recent chatter regarding Kyle Rittenhouse? Apparently a couple of years ago, he attempted to join the Marines. He did not get in, but it was never made clear as to why he didn't get in. That is, until now. It's being reported that Kyle Rittenhouse did so poorly on the USMC entrance exam, he has been permanently banned from applying again. And no, I'm not joking. As y'all can see here, back in January of 2020, this would be when Kyle Rittenhouse was 17. Actually, this was prior to the shooting that made him infamous. Kyle Rittenhouse applied to be a Marine, did so poorly on the entrance exam. He has been permanently banned. I'll see if I can read this writing. It is pretty small. We're gonna get up close and personal here. In follow-up to the Rittenhouse request, the most received confirmation through U.S. Army and USMC recruiting command efforts that in January 2020 he took a USMC entrance exam and did not meet service eligibility requirements. His test score was far below the required minimum and was permanently disqualified from entering the USMC. Now keep in mind, y'all, he took that test 6 months before he ended up shooting and unaliving two people. I don't know when he got his exam results back, but I think it's interesting to think about, like, if Kyle Rittenhouse...
Dishonest, look at this. He's got a Nogla.
Rittenhouse got his result before he carried out the shooting. Let's say he got in. Would that shooting have ever even happened? Or vice versa, was any part of the shooting motivated by the fact that he didn't get in? Would we even know who Kyle Rittenhouse is? Would we have ever seen him in this light?
He's so goofy looking.
There's a lot of questions we can...
So goofy looking.
Ask, I have two on my mind. The number one, what the hell would this dude look like with a buzz cut? That's gonna haunt me when I go to bed tonight. And number two, how badly did he do on this exam? Like, I've had job interviews that I know I didn't do great on, but to be permanently banned from, like, filling out another application.
Also, I just realized that this Uncle Sam says, stop voting for stupid people.
To enter that job, that's insane. If you watching this video have ever taken one of these exams, do let me know in the comment section, please. I want to know, how on earth did he fail this poorly? In the end though, as maybe weird as it sounds, I think it's good that things went the way that they did. The last thing we needed was for Kyle Rittenhouse to have legitimate military training. Most of us agree he should be in prison, but you know, At least karma appears to be kicking them in the butt.
Yeah. Wow, it looks like it's on fire. Someone commented saying the only way to be banned is by scoring in the single digits. Kind of like the IQ of the flat earth people.
No video games back then, I guess.
Machiko?
Poor, deprived kids.
Test your skills in memory of memory and retention with this fun matching game. Select corresponding pieces to clear the board and win. Yeah, also when my phone screen wasn't working, I was like, oh no, what am I going to do all day at work tomorrow? Over the Alps board game. A key to the hippie van? It's gotta be.
Aha! This must be the key to the van! Oh, how fun! Wait, did they not get to use these?
25 cents admission price. Good for one hayride. Showtime Drive-In Theater. Admit one. Michigan State Fair. Wait, I couldn't call mom on those. Yeah, okay. All right, so we got the key to the hippie van. I guess let's finish clearing this room. There's a fork. So I was at the grocery store yesterday, and I was standing in line, and the Blues Brothers song came on. Now, my brain keeps singing it.
Oh my god, Aunt August. I have so many questions.
A Luigi board? A Luigi board? Planchette for the Luigi board? A Ouija board? Dear August, you were upset after what happened today, and that's alright. You needed time to yourself instead of talking to me, and that's alright too. But upset as you are, you need to remember boys only tease girls because they like them. Nuh-uh. Or because they're different. You cannot control the cruelty of others, but you can discourage it through your own appearance and behavior, or learn to play along. It's time to grow up now. I know you will. Love, Mother. Gotta grow up, damn it. Took that exam in high school just to see what career best suits my mind. Engineering was first and common sense was second. I recall my overall score. I don't remember what I got on any of those tests. I don't know if I agree with this advice. What did it say?
I don't know if I agree with this advice. This doesn't sound very Millie to me.
Millie was just a character, honey.
I know, but didn't she usually give advice Grandma would have given? How could you tell a little kid that getting picked on was their own fault?
I don't know if that's what she meant.
It's right here. She's like, if people are mean to you, you should change. What, the bullies are right? She never told me that kind of thing when girls were being mean to me at school. She just told me to be myself.
I guess... Well, maybe if Mother could have gone back and given August the advice she gave you instead, she would have...
I hope so.
Here's the song I was talking about. Well, my baby complicated, let my mule to ride. Copyright. Watercolors? What is that supposed to be a picture of? Oh, probably this. Little Artist Watercolors. She complicated. Left me a meal. Ooh, treasure map! This looks like the hand of August. This looks like the hand of a bootlegger.
I knew it!
Knew what?
This map could only be the directions to the lost bootlegger gold.
Tess, this was clearly drawn by a child.
Perhaps it was a particularly childlike bootlegger.
Seems more like August to me.
Looks like she was just playing buried treasure. Do you think there'd be anything there to dig up that was left behind? It'd be like a time capsule.
Maybe she was gonna come back for it later. It was her first investment.
She got started early. I don't know. Let's just go see what it is.
I found a map to buried treasure in August's room. Could it be the fabled bootlegger gold? Probably not. But it might be something cool. The X marks the spot near the doghouse. Alright. I think we're about done in here anyway. The Mean Boys by August Devine. One day, August rode her bike to town because of how sunny it was. Because it was sunny, her friend Nightshade had to follow behind under the trees because she lives in the shade and shadows and I can't go in the sun. Oh, and she lives in the shade and shadows and can't go in the sun. August laughed as Nightshade ran along under the trees. And she and Nightshade made jokes together. When August and Nightshade got to the town, there were boys outside the general store. They saw August's special tie that made her safe, but it didn't make her safe from... them. The Mean Boys came closer. They said, "Who are you talking to? And what are you wearing, stupid?" August said, "My dad's tie." The Mean Boy said, "Your dad must be stupid, stupid." August was crying, but the Mean Boys didn't care. They laughed and laughed. August looked for Nightshade, but Nightshade couldn't help because he was trapped in the shade under the tree far away. I was thinking Nightshade was a girl. Trapped under the tree far away. When the Mean Boys went away, August went under the tree with Nightshade. August's special tie was all dirty. She gave Nightshade a hug to feel better, but it didn't help enough.
Poor kid. Did she get made fun of a lot? At school and stuff?
I think she got picked on when she was little, but she toughened up. I guess right around this age, when we came back from our last summer trip.
What changed?
I don't know.
Rumors of a Naruto anime remake are being spread. So the only reason that I even know the name Naruto is because of that guy who was saying... who was trying to get people together to storm Area 51. And he said to Naruto run, and then the bullets can't hit him. And then also in Satisfactory, if you do one of the emotes enough times, you'll shoot out some fire or something. But if it weren't for those two things, I wouldn't know what you were talking about. Under the bed. Well, let's... Alright, so we got the key for outside. And we got a treasure map. Okay, so we cleared this room. Before we go down here and look at that room and that room and that room, let's go out to the van and get the treasure. We can't get into August's room. Oh. Alright, so there's buried treasure back here.
Will my baby complicated? You ready to unearth this mystery?
You are really getting into the mess on this trip. Crawling through old crawl spaces, digging in the dirt.
It's for the sake of the adventure, Mom.
Don't let me stop you.
Ooh. I found a box. With a drawing? Under the tree. Oh, that's Nightshade and August under the tree? There's the tie. Goodbye, Nightshade. Thank you for being my friend. I'll miss you, August.
So this is where August buried her feelings.
Mom! Come on, it's sad. What?
I don't know. Maybe we should keep it. Maybe August would want it.
I think so too. I think we should leave it here. No, let's keep
it. I think so too.
We can just put it in the car.
Welcome back, Nightshade.
Do not go gentle into the good Nightshade. It turns out the real treasure was the friends we made along the way. JK, it was actually the grave of August's imaginary friend Nightshade. I feel kind of bad for disturbing it. How does my mic sound now? Because I turned the gain up a little bit and I put it farther away from my mouth. Like sometimes I'll actually just be touching it with my face. But does it sound better with it like far away like that? And the gain up a little bit higher? Alright, we got the van. Left my mule to ride, the train pulled out. And van.
Oh, it's everything I'd imagined. It's got an ugly lamp.
I think it would be better with red curtains with white polka dots.
An acoustic guitar. A concerning scent of mold?
Mm-hmm. I mean, what do you expect? It's been under Rats. This carport for 30 years. That's why I'm not coming inside.
Okay, I'll just look around and get out. It is kind of gross in here.
But you're letting your kid be exposed to 30 years of mold? Dude, I gotta get a lava lamp. I can't put it behind me. I could put it up here, but you guys can't see all the cool stuff I got up here. Maybe at the new house.
Alas, not so groovy anymore.
What is this? What is this? Can't even play the guitar. What the hell kind of hippie van is this?
Wow. Mom was even into theater back then. Huh.
Oh! Another thing I got. Think. What is it? Alone in the Dark has a free prologue. So I got that. I want to do that tomorrow. What time do you guys want to play tomorrow? First thing or later? Murder at Montague. Montague Manor, adapted for the stage by Monty Prentice. Okay. Whoa, why am I so fast right now? Death of a Salesman. The School for Scandal. What is this? I can't even pick it up.
Wow. Brutal, Lori. Brutal. But kind of fair.
Dear Opal, are you getting my letters? I haven't heard from you since you told me about Kurt. I've been writing you every week. Things at the park are lame. All the fun people left, and now it's just me, Gordon, and the dorks from Sandusky. Ohio? If I don't get anything back, I'm just going to assume you're too preoccupied with Kurt to write to me. At least one of us is having fun. I'll talk to you when school starts, I guess, unless I'm too busy. Lori. Uh-oh. She kind of flaked off on her friend and then never talked to her again? Sabino 120 Owner's Manual. Screwdriver? I'll take that. What is it? Phillips?
Holy shit.
Ooh, it's a letter from Kurt. Babe, this summer's been real out there, but I've got a split. I'm not hip to another winter with snow. I'm on my bike headed to Cali. Look me up if you're ever out that way. Kurt. Ooh, Mom. I think that's it. Nothing like super exciting in here. Okay.
How was the stuff? Groovy as you'd hoped?
Yeah.
Well, I found,
just a screwdriver in the glove box, that's it. This note from Kurt.
This. You guys didn't just drift apart at the end of the summer, did you?
No. I came to work at the diner one night, and they said someone had left a note for me. And it was this stupid thing.
That sucks, Mom.
I just felt like such an idiot. I'd put all my energy into plans, planning how we'd be able to stay together, planning how our life was going to be, planning how he'd be the answer for how I was going to be okay. And then one day, this. I don't know if I've ever cried as much as I did for the week after I got this.
Stream Deck, something is happening. I can't switch. Let's try to restart it and see what happens. Okay. What the hell happened? I'm still live. I gotta switch it manually by clicking it. What the hell happened? I can't even bring my camera back out. I have to... click it. Weird. What the hell's going on? Well, I could go unplug it and plug it, but I don't feel like it. He seems like an asshole. He seems like maybe he just wanted something different than you.
He seems like maybe he just wanted something different than you.
Well, he could have told me that. Instead, he just played along, told me what I wanted to hear. Until one day it was just goodbye. Not even face to face, just this selfish little note. And he was gone. There was a lesson I should have learned that summer. You can't rely on other people.
What?
If you put your trust in other people, if you expect them to be there for you, one day they won't be.
So you just shouldn't have friends or relationships?
So what? You shouldn't have friends or relationships?
Well, no, I just mean you can care about other people, but you have to be ready for them to go away and be okay on your own when they do.
You're making it sound like... Are you saying Dad left you? I thought you said you both agreed to get divorced.
Here, let me screw with this while they're talking. I'm just going to shut off my camera. And I'm going to mute.
Well, either way, he's not here, is he?
Mom, what happened? With you and Dad splitting up. He always makes it sound like you wanted him to leave, but...
He does?
I mean,
if he's telling you I wanted this, I... See? This is why you need to be okay on your own. If you're fine on your own, when they leave, you don't have to feel this way. Remember
that. I fixed
it.
I also found this little screwdriver.
Okay. That might come in handy.
You just read the Naruto one? Did you hear what I said about it? The only reason that I have ever heard of Naruto is that guy a few years ago that was posting on Facebook to get a bunch of people together to... storm Area 51, and he said you could just Naruto run past the bullets. And then Satisfactory's got an Easter egg. What are we doing now? It turns out the real treasure was... Okay. I guess we're going back in and looking at the other... So Mom did not like to talk about her old boyfriend. Didn't like Naruto? I don't even know. I've never seen 100% of anime. Other than Laura watched Avatar a bunch of times, and I've seen it on a few times. And then I did watch Full Metal Alchemist, like the live action movie.
What's in here?
That was my mom and dad's room.
And that was interesting.
Just my mom's room last we were here.
Look, I think I could twist this open from the inside with that little screwdriver I found.
Hey, good work.
Thanks, Mom.
And when I used to listen to Hassan every day, he was watching One Piece. So I heard about it every day from him. Ew, somebody pooped in the corner. Nice wood paneling, nice wallpaper. What do we got? This space is for writing messages. Darling, now wait. It sounds like someone's getting cold feet all of a sudden. We had a plan. Leo dies, I make tracks for the border. And when the dust settles, you follow me. This doesn't work if only one of us makes tracks. I've got everything you could ever hope for up here. A place of our own. A quiet little town where nobody knows our names. in a pile of cash that'll keep us going till who knows when. The kids will love it too. What kid wouldn't want to live on a boat? Get these silly ideas out of your head. Get back on track, and we'll be together soon. So I don't know if I'd want to live on a boat. Even when we went to Lake McConaughey, I had a life jacket on. And when I got to the point in the lake where I couldn't touch the ground anymore, it was too deep, I didn't like it at all. I didn't want to go past there. Libertyville, Michigan. Disco Heartbreaker Star Hot Sanas Hot Sam's Hot Sing Song Hot Wait Star Hot Songs Super. Okay. A Bibble. Let's read it. There's gotta be something in there, right? Something hidden. The Ligniap astrology book? I don't even know. What about this notebook?
Freaky. Yet appealing.
Yeah, that's kind of scary.
Oh, Grandma.
Nothing? Seriously? You gonna come in here and not check the drawers? Easter goose. Break that open, there's hidden stuff in there. King, queen, royal flush.
Ah, my mom loved this desk. I remember when she brought it home from the flea market.
Jeez, how many desks did Grandma have?
Kind of a lot, I guess. I mean, she was a writer. She liked to move around.
Well, let's see what she was hiding in here. Ugh, it's locked.
Everything's locked.
This gives me an idea.
Oh, guess what I have? The little key from Grandma's diary.
The little key? From Grandma's diary? Right.
I was gonna use the screwdriver. Yeah. Grandma and Grandpa. Sympathy card. Our condolences. Our thoughts are with you, Jeanette and David Richards. Now Grandpa died. With one deepest sympathies. Our thoughts are with you, Helen. So sorry to hear about your loss. Please let me know if there's anything we can do. The Saltzmans. The Saltine Crackers. Why can't I pick up all the ashtrays? This is the same ashtray as at the house with this lighthouse or whatever's in there. Yep, looks like a pen. Helen, you can't just leave me here. I did all this for you. All for you. And those are my kids too, you know. I have a right. Flip over. Pierre Lutric. Box 9, Hopto Lake, Carindale, Ontario, Canada. Hey, Mom.
What's that?
I'm sorry. What?
What does he mean? When he says those are his kids? Was Grandpa Leo not your real dad? Could that have been why he was trying to run away with you in August and Grandma Helen?
I can't even imagine.
Look, Mom. Look. This one. This note. It has a return address. Pierre Lutric. Box 9. Hopto Lake. Carindale, Ontario.
Let's go. Do you have your passport? We should go check it out. Don't you want to go check it out? No, we should go check it out.
We should go check it out.
What? No.
No? But...
Tess! We already drove however many hours up here and dug around getting dirty and all this stuff. I'm not driving us to Canada based on some return address from over 30 years ago. We have the rest of the house to pack up, and I still need to call the electric company to schedule our end of the service, which I probably should have done sooner and...
Mom, stop.
Call him right now. Oh, that's right. You probably don't have a cell phone. Oh, yeah, we do. You got a flip phone. This is your father we're talking about here. It's about who you really are. The house can wait a day. This can't. You're going to pass up a trip to Canada?
The house can wait a day. This can't.
The house actually can't wait.
A day? I mean, come on. It can't be that far of a drive. It says it's right across the border. And if we don't do it now, you think we're really ever gonna come back? You could find out who this guy really was. Who your father really was. Who we really are. But not if we just turn around and go home.
Okay, listen.
Yes.
Hey, I'm not doing this because of your sterling rhetorical skills. You didn't win this one. I just happen to agree with you. I do want to know who my mother might have been mixed up with, and why she never told me about it, and who my real father is. And if we go check out this address, we might find nothing. But we might find something.
We might find everything.
So if one more day of driving is all it takes to find out one way or the other...
Then why not, right?
Right.
Glad I could convince you.
No, you just happened to be right.
Exactly. Glad you came around to see things my way in the end. Okay, should we get going? It's getting dark.
Yeah, let's find somewhere to stay for the night. We'll look up directions, get back on the road in the morning.
Let's go.
Hotel night. We're getting room service. Thank you, Mom.
Best weekend ever. Had room service.
But we didn't find that hidden fortune you were so...
Best weekend ever. I already played that.
Excited about.
Yeah.
No, it was best month ever.
Maybe it's on the other side of the border.
Maybe. Come on, let's get out of here.
Wait, I didn't check that room yet. Okay. What the heck? Is this Pierre Lutric guy, Mom's real dad? Scandal. We found an address for some place in Canada. We've got to check it out. Time to hit the road. So I wonder when this game saves. Alright, I didn't check in here yet. Do you have your passport? Did you get your shots? Hair clip? Comb? Oh, Grandma. Look at that Mustang right there. Wait, that's like a 2004 Mustang. Or a 99. Which would have been like 4 or 5 years ago. Wait. Yeah.
Now, what is this?
During the summers when we'd come here, I had a summer job as a waitress at the drive-in.
On roller skates? Like in the movies?
Yeah, I guess. If those movies were based on reality, you know.
You were cute. You looked like a real dork.
You were cute!
Oh, I don't know.
Oh, please, Mom, stop. You were cute then, and you're, hot mom now.
What?
According to the boys at school, you are my hot mom. You didn't know about this?
No! I am not.
Oh, yeah. No, it's great. It's great having all the boys at school talking about how hot your mom is. It's great.
There's
always
one.
Regardless, this photo of you is real neat, and I think we should keep it.
Sure. Why not?
There's always a kid in your class, or... Oh, what? Walter Skater found a photo of Opal roller skating. There's always a kid in your class, or, you know, plus or minus a year, that's got a hot mom. I couldn't look at it again. Next time, let both your tempers simmer down before you try to make amends. Confidential to Precious Stone. You're saying idealistic and... Wait. Ugh. You're young, idealistic, and you trust easily. You have an open heart and a lot of pain to heal. Don't let someone who's more flash than substance take advantage of that. Look for advice. Or looking for advice? Write to Millie. Oh, Millie's grandma's show. Need help right away? Try Millie's new book.
Precious Stone?
This was you? Grandma was writing advice to rocks?
This was to you?
Subtle, right? My mother was against me and Kurt being together from the start. To be fair, I would go off to who knows where with him and sometimes not come back till the morning. Now I understand how worried she must have been as a mother.
You were a bad kid? Do you ever thank your lucky stars I'm not a bad kid?
I don't know. You and Francine can stay up pretty late.
Playing The Sims and eating pizza rolls.
Yeah.
Yeah, you kids are wild these days.
Playing Fortnite. Ooh, secret letter. Opal, I thought I was the one who was going to have all the fun this summer. Before Kurt, I'm so jealous. A Casanova with a motorcycle. Jeez Louise, I've never even been on a motorcycle. I've been seeing this boy named Gordon here. He's not as fun as Kurt, but he's cute and really sweet. Art, less than three. He runs the log flume, and he's into model airplanes and ham radio. No motorcycle for me. Write back soon and tell me everything. I need something to read before Gordon bores me to death talking about planes. Your very best log-fluming, non-motorcycling friend, Lori. Why is it in the garbage? Con shampoo is better. I go on first and clean the hair. Conditioner is better. I leave the hair silky and smooth. Oh, really, fool? Really? The devs don't want you spending too much time looking at the photo, if you know what I mean. It couldn't have been that bad. All right. Well, I think we're done here. Let's go. Shampoo is better. I go on first and clean the hair. Conditioner is better. Later, dude. going mobile. Explore the trailer home. All right. And mobile home.
Time to order that room service.
This is not the kind of place that has a room service. I'm sorry.
What?
Hotels do room service. This is a motel.
Just like the summer place was a mobile home and not a trailer.
Right. But the other way around. But there's a restaurant and lounge right next door, though. I'm gonna head down there and get us dinner, okay? And I'm going to have a cocktail while I wait. It's been a long day. I'll be back with something to eat soon.
Well, all right. That's almost like room service.
What do you want to eat?
Oh, burger?
Burger it is. Do your homework.
I knew I shouldn't have brought my backpack on this trip. Now Mom expects me to do my homework. Well, I guess there's not much else to do cooped up in this motel room. When we went to North Carolina, it would have been in 2018 because the championship NASCAR race was happening when we were there. We stayed at a hotel, and on the way back to the hotel, after looking at houses, we stopped at Bojangles and got a bunch of fried chicken and stuff like that. I don't remember a lot about it, but it was good. Bojangles. Them and the fire escape map.
Notify the blah blah blah. Beware. Da, da, da. Be sure. Da, da, da. Got it.
Got it. All right. Oh, shampoo is better.
Oh, I yeah. Definitely stealing these.
I go on first and clean the hair. Conditioner is better. All right. Well, I got started late tonight, which means I went late tonight. And man, I felt kind of crappy in the morning today. Just like always, except I kept hitting the snooze. And then I don't know if I would just slept through the alarm or what, but I got up at 7:04 and I have to leave. Well, I try to leave at 7, but I could leave as late as like 7:15 and make it to work like just on time to go 16 miles. So I got up, I looked at the clock and I was like, oh shit, got up, got dressed, packed my lunch and was out the door. And I wasn't late. I got there like 4 minutes early. So I am going to call it a night, but before I do, let's check out the Alone in the Dark prologue. Which, okay, wait, I want to do this tomorrow. Do you guys want to play Deceit 2? Do you guys want to play that first thing on stream or a couple hours in? Because if you want to play it later, I will start the night with this.
I need to get this letter to my niece. She would understand.
Here, let me do it.
What?
They're so creepy.
Whoa. Alone in the Dark, Grace. Grace in the Dark, Prologue. Nordic. TH... Nordic.
There is.
The following in-game footage may contain maddening and/or haunting images. Viewer discretion is advised.
There is a house in New Orleans. They call the rising sun. to salvation have gone. Oh God,
she putting
knows
a noose on her?
I'm one.
What?
Don't let him get inside, Compere. They're not the good guy.
Dorsetto isn't cursed or blessed. It's a battleground.
Maybe the Dark Man just likes it when you suffer.
Have you ever talked to a doctor about your condition?
This is madness!
Are you crazy?
I gotta play this.
Fall on your knees, wear the mask, raise his name!
Also,
welcome to the Madhouse, Detective.
Also, it's got the cop from Stranger Things. Gotta play this. The standalone prologue puts you in the tiny shoes of Grace Saunders, an 11-year-old girl delivering a letter when things go horribly wrong. Experience the unique 1920s horror atmosphere in Alone in the Dark and prepare for the terror that awaits in Dorsetto Manor? $60 for the main game? What do you guys think? Do you want to play first thing tomorrow or later? If no one says anything, I'm just going to play Alone in the Dark first. All right, it's up to them. Zaylin, Malik, do you guys want to play first thing on stream tomorrow or later on in the night? Around 12. Okay, so that's 10 my time. I'll be at work, so it'll be you. Okay, so you get off work 10 my or home 10 my time also. So it sounds like we're playing around 10 to 10:30-ish. So I'm going to play Alone in the Dark Prologue first thing tomorrow. Which I didn't even know. But there's the Lovecraftian days going on right now. So I want this game. Wait, do we have a... Do we have a decadent? Decadent. Oh, there's no trailer? There's just this? Redoing Deceit 2? Yeah, this sounds good to me. Slay the Princess? I played a demo for that a while back. Can someone type the game in the Discord? Yeah, let me pause. It's anyway, this is the game that I put on my wish list. It's not out yet. It is Deceit 2. We'll go ahead and install that. It is this one. Here, I'll put it in game suggestions in the Discord also. All right. Only up with friends? It's only $4. We should play that too. This looks like I'm either going to like it or not. Like I'm going to be into it or it's going to suck. I don't know. Didn't spend any money for a while. That Deceit 2 game is free. This one is free. Free to play. Haha. No excuses. Ooh, there's even crossplay. Oh, for only up? Yeah, well, I would only buy it for us to play like once, and then we'd probably never play it again, so that's fine. All right, I gotta get going to bed. It's gonna be like 11:30 by the time I'm in bed. But it is Friday, so as long as I can get through the day, I'll be back around 8 p.m. Mountain Time, MST. We're going to play Alone in the Dark Prologue, which I'm actually super excited for. I did not know there was a prologue. Finish this one first, stupid. Yeah, I'm excited. All right, well, thanks for coming to hang out tonight, everybody. I really do appreciate it. If you enjoyed the stream, make sure you follow, turn on notifications, and if you'd like to support the channel, avoid seeing the ads, and you'd also be welcome to join my private Satisfactory server and come play with us, which Satisfactory 1.0 is releasing this year with the full story, which we don't know anything about yet. And we're going to reset the server when that happens so we can start at the beginning and get all the story. All you got to do is subscribe for $5 or for free with a Twitch Prime. Otherwise, you got to be lucky and get gifted a sub. So I will talk to you all tomorrow. Let me see something. All right. That's it for me. Have a good night, everybody. And I will talk to you tomorrow. Pull me out from the cage I've known. Later, guys.